It's 6:09 now, and Calgary is among the most affordable major housing markets in this country for first-time buyers. Good news is Calgary's housing market had its strongest September in 6 years, and that's pretty impressive during a pandemic. But one sector still struggling, and that's condominiums. So with more, we'll find out from realtor Justin Havre with Justin Havre and Associates REMAX First. Hi, Justin.
Hi, Sue and Andrew. How are you guys doing this morning?
Excellent. Thank you so much for joining us. First off, wow, an impressive September. Were you surprised by the rebound, or were realtors kind of seeing that coming?
You know, I don't think any of us were seeing that, or we're going to predict that we're going to have a strong housing market, once we had the shutdown here from the COVID in April. But, with the incredibly low interest rates and people's desire for perhaps a little more space and getting into single family homes has definitely spurred some great activity in the housing market.
Hearing about the single family homes, Justin, but the condos, typically, I always thought that condos always, kind of had their own life in such a specific segment of the market. Condos not doing quite as well. Tell us about that.
Yeah, the apartment sector, I mean, especially here in Calgary, has had a lot of downward pressure, especially since the economic downturn in 2015. And we have had a lot of supply in that segment for many years, and there's a lot of developers even sitting there with unsold inventory. Now, with the pandemic, it has also perhaps shifted people's desire for condominiums, because people now desire a little more space, perhaps, a home office and a backyard and that kind of stuff. So, along with that, you have also people kind of reconsidering wanting living in an apartment style building where there's obviously high density, and people want to kind of get away from the virus for the time being. Now, I believe that there's some great opportunities for those people that are looking to get into the market, in the apartment sector.
So are you seeing on the selling side then that people are just trying to kind of unload condos and so therefore selling them at a cheaper price because there's a glut?
Well, I mean, when the supply is high and demand is low, I mean, that's definitely going to have an impact on pricing, right? So people that do choose to sell their apartments in this time and space that we're in, they definitely have to have, some thick skin, because, they're going to have to be very competitive on their pricing to attract the right buyer for their place.
So who do you think would be the perfect buyer? And I know you mentioned the pandemic, but who is buying condos? Who's the main audience you're looking at?
Well, typically, I mean, if there was young professionals working downtown, obviously the employment segment in the downtown Calgary market has also changed, right? So, I would say it's the young professionals that still are employed or working in the downtown core may want to look at some opportunities down there. We're also seeing some investors now entering the market where they're picking up the condominiums at lower pricing where, the numbers make sense for them.
Are there some downsides to condos, Justin, or have things changed in terms of rules and regulations and that sort of thing?
Well, I mean, when you're buying an apartment, you're buying for the lifestyle, right? Some people may not want to do the exterior maintenance, landscaping, snow removal, right? So, I mean, it's a lifestyle that people are buying into. So for the people that like the convenience and, like to be in a building where they have some great amenities, gyms, some buildings even have, swimming pools and other amenities as well. So, people that are seeking that kind of lifestyle, it's definitely a great opportunity.
It would seem to me when you mention opportunity, when I travel to other cities, I think about Vancouver Island, Edmonton for that matter. When I've done Airbnb or VRBO, it's generally been the condos because I want to be close to the downtown core. So that could be a good idea. I mean, obviously, COVID aside, although we're hearing that Airbnb have some incredible protocols, is this something that, perhaps a buyer could get into and utilize a condo for?
They definitely can. Now, they would have to check the bylaws in the building that they're purchasing to see if the bylaws allow short-term rentals. Mm-hmm. Now, there are some condo corporations that are putting some strict restrictions on that. So definitely do your due diligence, speak with a real estate professional or a condominium document reviewer for guidance on that.
So some definite great bargains to be had in the condo world. Justin, before we let you go, outside of condos, if I'm thinking about a move, what's the rest or the rest of the market looking like in terms of what might be a good investment for me right now?
Well, you know, the single family segment seems to be always, seems to be desirable, right? So right now we're seeing a lot of activity in the single family detached segment between $400,000 and $600,000. Now there's some great opportunities for those people that are looking to move up in the higher price points where, you know, there's less activity and some great opportunities. All the sellers these days have to have a little bit of a reality check and price their properties, whether it's apartments or single-family homes, to be competitive, because, you know, there is definitely some competition out there. And, you know, more space seems to be the going trend these days.
Also, you know, if you have to sell, you might be thinking, oh, the snow is falling, it's getting colder. But that doesn't necessarily have to get in your way of putting your house up for sale, should it, Justin?
No, I mean, we typically do see that, you know, the real estate market does slow down once we get some snow on the ground, and it starts to pick up again typically in April, May. Now, you know, people are still transacting even over Christmas, and, you know, don't let the winter stop you from putting your house on the market if you're in a position where you do need to sell or want to make a move.
Do you think this will change things in the real estate world, Justin? With, I know, you know, you guys at Justin Havre and Associates, Remax First, you've got virtual tours of homes. Do you think it'll stay that way once we get beyond this?
I definitely do think it will stay this way because, I mean, it's a convenience for the consumer while they're shopping online, right? If you can sit in the comfort of your home, and especially during this pandemic, you can sit at home safely, tour homes from the warmth and comfort of your couch, and I do believe that these 3D virtual tours will definitely stay around after the pandemic is over as well.
Boy, so technologically advanced. Mm-hmm. It seems like the realtors are leading the charge when it comes to the tech. And Justin, you're no different. Thank you for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me. Have a wonderful day.
You
too. Stay safe and healthy.
That is Justin Havre, realtor with Justin Havre and Associates, Remax First.